Television has changed many ways throughout the years, from black and white TV to 3D, from no sound to surround sound. Picture quality has improved and sound quality has improved, and the way we watch television now would be unimaginable to the original creators. Charles Jenkins was an American pioneer of early cinema and one of the inventors of television. He was responsible for inventing the early forms of mechanical television. It was on June 13, 1925 that he publicly demonstrated synchronized transmission of pictures and sound. His work with mechanical technology was later overtaken by electronic television, such as devised by Vladimir Dworkin and Philo Farnsworth. Philo Farnsworth was an American inventor and television pioneer. He made contributions that were crucial to the early development of electronic television. He is perhaps best known for his 1927 invention of the first fully functional all-electronic image pickup device, also known as the video camera tube, as well as the first fully functional and complete electronic television system. He was also the first person to demonstrate an electrical television system to the public. Vladimir Dworkin was a Russian inventor, engineer, and pioneer of television technology. Educated in Russia and in France, he spent most of his life in the United States. Dworkin invented a television transmission and receiving system employing cathode ray tubes. He played a role in the practical development of television from the early 30s, including charge storage type tubes, infrared image tubes, and the electron microscope.
So after World War II, television started becoming more popular and commercially sold, and people started buying them for their homes. They originally were big boxy TVs, always cathode ray tubes were used in the back of them, so it was all mechanical based. That's why they're so big and bulky. They were usually bought in, when they first came out, as 12-inch screens. Usually they're curved as well. And then not until the early 50s, they started coming out with color TVs. And then as we progressed on through the years, they started becoming more LCD based, and they got a lot thinner because there wasn't had to be all these different mechanics in the back of it, but then they started expanding the screen size of them from anywhere from, now you see it's like more 40-inch TVs in some people's houses and go up all the way up to 90-inch TVs. They're even curved now. There's 3D TVs, so like the entire TV set has been wiped and started over pretty much with these new LCDs. Well, not new now, but yeah. But now, in the past 100 years, we went from having just the start of television to now having these massive TVs that you see everywhere. And like thinking of like New York City, for matter, like they have massive screens that they post up on buildings and stuff, and they work the exact same way pretty much. So going from these little box 12-inch TVs to that is astonishing in the past 100 years, and I'm sure that we'll do even more incredible things with the TV system in years on.
So the first color system was developed by John Baird in 1928 and used mechanical techniques. In 1950, the FCC tried out the CBS with a compatible system by RCA. Back then, RCA gave a poor picture quality. In late 1953, the FCC adopted the RCA compatible system, also known as the NTSC system. The first color television set for the system was sold in 1954 and had a 15-inch screen. Later on that year, they made screens 19-inch, and at the end of 1957, only 150,000 color sets had been sold. The sales were slow until the mid-1960s, when prices came down and more color programming became available. Around the late 1960s, color sets became more reliable and cheaper, and more network TV shows were televised in color. That is why color sales grew. It wasn't until 1970 when color set sales exceeded black and white.
I'm here to talk to you about the television quality over these last few years. And by these last few years, I mean nearly 100 of them. So TV has been around for decades, but you wouldn't even believe the increase of quality over all the years. In 1939, RCA revealed the first black and white television set that were sold to the American public. You could probably guess the quality wasn't that great, and there was obviously no color. So color television started in the 1940s, but it wasn't viable until the 1950s. Since these televisions weren't HD, they are considered standard definition televisions. The quality was getting better over the years, but not good enough for them to be considered HD TVs. In 1993, HDTV was now official, something that wasn't standard definition for the first time. High definition is any TV screen that is 720p, with the resolution being 1280 by 720 pixels. That is over double the resolution of a standard definition TV. In 1993, HDTV finally became a thing. It was the first screen that wasn't standard definition. HDTV is basically any screen that's 720p with the resolution being 1280 by 720 pixels. That is double the resolution of standard definition TV. After HDTV came out, well, a while after, they announced something called Full HD. A 1080p television screen is considered Full HD and has the resolution of 1920 by 1080 pixels. Being almost double the size of the 720p TV screen means it would have nearly double the pixels in it, which makes it very clear that it would be nearly double the quality. No pun intended back when I said clearly. A while after Full HD TV came out is when television got really out of hand. This is when 4K television came out. A 4K television is 3840 by 2160 pixels. And is much larger than the resolution of a full HD TV, and it is double the size, which again means double the pixels and double the quality. 4K television is the most dominant and most popular TV screen right now, and it is to be said that in 2020, nearly half the households in America will own a TV that is 4K quality. The highest quality we have today in this world is UHD TV, which is an 8K TV with a resolution of 7860 by 4320. This television is extremely expensive because it is double the size and double the pixels of 4K television. Although it is around, it is very uncommon because of the extreme price. No television channels right now stream in 8K, but it is to be said that the Olympics in 2020 will be streamed in 8K in Japan.
Jason.
8K is here, but at the same time it isn't, because I don't have access to it. Neither do you.
And that's it for the history of television.